Ladies and gentlemen, live from Kelvin University, it's The Tonight Show!
Yes! Welcome to The Tonight Show. I'm your host, Jack Droppers. We have an overwhelmingly great show for you all tonight. Tonight's show will feature two new friends to the show, all the way from Los Angeles, California. Comedian Michael Palascak will sit down with me, and we'll have a performance by Taylor Goldsmith from Dawes. But first, let's catch up on some news. It was announced that Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos will be opening a preschool this year. So, bad news to people who like to steal packages. One of those packages might have a kid in it. Personally, I'll be sending any future children of mine to Bill Gates' dance instructional school. Last week, an 89-year-old man, that's right, 89-year-old man, who happens to be a Papa John's delivery driver, got a huge surprise when he received a $12,000 tip from a customer, and that customer's, quote, TikTok family. Now, the man can finally retire in peace and will spend the rest of his life explaining what a TikTok family is to everyone at the retirement home. Also last week, Governor Whitmer announced that Michigan will become the final state to open up movie theaters in the U.S. However, theaters will still remain under a strict safety protocol that limits them to 20% occupancy in their theaters. So congratulations to Sonic the Hedgehog, which will inevitably be the second highest grossing film of 2020. In Kelvin news, as of Friday, students are now allowed to hang out with the other people who live on their same floor. But introverts, I'd love to share with you five ways that you can still get some alone time without appearing antisocial. Number one, wear a college t-shirt. Really? You're still bleeping out college? You can't say anymore? Anyway, number two, lightly cough every time someone passes your room in the hallway. Number three, invite your friends to watch an SAO movie in the dark while it's 35 degrees out. Number four, host a stand-up comedy open mic. And number five, ask them if they want to come over and watch The Tonight Show. Finally, if you're watching this live, it means you've chosen to skip the first 20 minutes of the first presidential debate. But luckily for you, let's get a live update of what's going on.
Hey!
Looks like a lot of fun. We'll be right back with Michael Palascak. All right, welcome back to what is apparently the Los Angeles edition of The Tonight Show. He has flown all the way to Grand Rapids from Los Angeles. By the time you see this, he's already done his two performances on the Commons Lawn, so you missed out if you didn't go to those. But here to be on the show, ladies and gentlemen, Michael Palascak.
Hello, thank you.
Yeah, welcome to the show.
I like it that you're assuming these are really going to happen. I like that positivity.
This is the thing that
is going
to happen.
In 2020, you can't just be like, it's going to happen. Yeah. Like, really?
So I want to talk about performing at colleges, but first, you did something that not a ton of us have done lately, which is went on an airplane.
Yes.
So how did it feel to be in the, you know, great petri dish of the sky?
Well, I made sure to sit in the last row. That way, everyone got my stuff.
Okay, that's good.
I only got their stuff if it just deflected off of my stuff. Yep. So I figured, like, my stuff would be like.
Is that how airplane air works?
Listen, I took Ken 1 a long time ago, and I'm pretty sure if my stuff, my air, yeah. So it was okay. It is weird though. I fly Southwest because they don't let someone sit in the middle. Because I flew Spirits a while ago, and they had a thing on their website where it said that they were ideally, like, they weren't going to have people sit in the middle.
Yeah.
And then I got there, and there was someone sitting, like, next to me, and I was like, I thought this, and they're like, oh, that's only if we need this middle. Well, that's how it always is. There's no one sitting in the middle, let's say, no one's like, ah, can I sit between you guys? Like,
so. Spirit Air might be the
company in the world that gets away with more things than any other company.
I like it because it's cheaper, but I also like it because it feels safer, because I don't think that anybody would ever blow up one of those planes.
Yeah, that's true.
Those attacks are coordinated. Those discount flights are not very coordinated.
Yes, for sure. Yeah, you don't want to have your knees against the seat in front of you for 4 hours just to do something evil.
Even if a terrorist got on one of those flights, he'd probably just look around and be like, these are not the Americans we're upset at.
Yeah, exactly.
I had to pay to carry on my bomb.
Yeah. One time I flew from LA to Detroit through Fort Lauderdale on Spirit. It was a 24-hour trip but I saved like $30, so it's worth it.
So I haven't done that far, but I've flown from LA to Chicago for $48 before on Spirit. Yeah. Lizzie, we're ripping into them now. It's free advertising.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. Yeah.
But fly Southwest, apparently.
No middle seats. Yeah.
No middle seats. Yeah. So LA and California in general has had... you've sort of arrived to the party late, but in fashion with coronavirus. Mm-hmm. In that, my wife and I have friends in LA, and we were talking to them in March, and they're like, "Yeah, it's not really a thing here," and then it became a thing very quickly. What have you noticed about maybe your neighbors or just the people that you interact with as it comes to that changing shift happening so quickly?
Yeah, I think people got really sensitive right away. Like, I have a 1-year-old son, and so we were kind of like really just careful. And I remember when it first hit in March, there was our neighbor that wanted to go to the grocery store with us. And we were like, "Hey, how are you feeling? Have you been whatever?" And she got so mad that we didn't even consider that she could possibly have this thing. And then a week later, she was wearing a mask all the time in Nepal. Like, it was just like, I think immediately people realized it's not a personal thing. It's just like part of being alive.
Does your 1-year-old know the word mask yet?
No.
Okay.
But he does, like, when we would go for walks in the morning, because it's LA, like, we were talking about, there's not a lot of, like, backyards and stuff, especially apartments. So we would go for a walk every morning, and I would always forget my mask to the point where we would go down the stairs, and I would have my mask, and he would, like, turn around to go back up, because he knew that was the pattern. Like, we go upstairs, he forgets his mask, he goes up, and we go get it.
That's great.
Yeah.
So, one of the things I'm curious about when it comes to comedy,
I feel
like we had an explosion in TV shows about comedians in the last decade.
Yes.
Most of them set in New York. Mm-hmm. And a lot of it has been the struggle of bombing night after night. And I'm curious, like, obviously that's something that happens to everyone. Is it like...
Hopefully not night after night.
Yeah, is it as bad as some of those shows make it out to be?
I think, first thing, I do think the one show I think of is Crashing with Pete Holmes, which I need to watch all of that here. It's great. But I do think it'd be hard as, like, if I were to get a TV show for that to be the show, because I wouldn't want to go... people to watch the show and think that I was actually bombing. Like, if you're going to script it, why script it? You're doing horrible. And I know it's good for the story, but... I think that it, especially at that level, like, if you're like a successful comedian, you're not always going to get laughs, but I think, like, there's not as much you put into every set. Not, you try every set and you want to, but, like, whether they laugh or not, this is just one step on the big journey that is my career and my life, so it's not as big of a deal.
Yeah.
And I think, like, also, sometimes it's just the surroundings. Sometimes there's just going to be 10 people there because it's a Monday, and you're there because you're working on your stuff, and they're there because they're tourists or something.
So. Yep. So you've done at least a couple shows to people wearing masks.
Yeah.
Can you tell if you're bombing, if someone's wearing a mask?
I think you're just always bombing. Yeah. You can't hear their laughs.
Nobody's having fun.
No. I did a show inside, and they were all wearing masks. I was like, this is just go outside. This is not.
Yeah.
I like the virtual shows, though, where I can see you and not hear you.
Yeah.
Because I just assume I'm destroying anytime you move at all.
Yeah.
And, like,
so you've done virtual shows where you can see the audience?
Yeah.
Okay.
And you can't see everybody, so it's fun because I'll have, like, someone book a show for me, and they're always worried, like, how many people are watching because they charge so much. And, and I can see, like, 5 boxes and everyone else is blacked out. I'm like, there's probably, like, 200 people there, and there's just probably, like, 10 people in each one. Yeah. So it's like you can't tell.
Yeah.
It's great.
That's interesting. So I'm a musician, and when I do a live stream, I can't see anyone.
Okay.
There's never anyone there. I never do it
over
Zoom.
No one's, like,
Zoom.
Rocking out, yeah.
And so you just always assume that nobody's listening. But to see their faces, like, do you That's like an intimate thing, though. Mm-hmm. Versus like at a club, you're at least 10 feet away from them. Like you're in their bedroom,
yeah,
and they've got their phone like this.
Yep.
Like, does that change the dynamic of like, I don't feel comfortable telling this joke? Or,
well, I feel like it is if I know them. Like, I've had family chime into the Zooms, not like closest family, but like some, and I feel like that's a little more sense because I can hear whether they laugh or not. Like, yeah. Oh, they didn't like that one or whatever. But with strangers, I think when people are watching something at home that's not like a TV show, it's a Zoom comedy show, they're almost more on board because they know they have to be.
Yeah.
And they know I can hear them, so they're laughing how they want to laugh, and they're surprised that they're laughing. Mm-hmm. And so it's fun in a different way rather than a live show.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
One last question, and then we got to play a game.
Yeah.
I don't know if you think of yourself in this way, but as a public speaker,
uh-huh.
I've been fascinated by the volume of people's voices when they do those things.
Yeah.
So not to pick on any political party, but one of the political parties happened to have a very loud national convention.
Yeah.
And do you feel like you have to be as loud when you're doing a live stream, or do you whisper jokes ever?
That's a good question. I feel like when I first started doing live streams, if I got loud, my internet would cut out. I got booked for like 10 corporate shows, and we did two, and they're like, you can't do it anymore because you're an internet.
That's so bad.
And so then I did more where I was just sort of like doing the jokes without being as vocally invested, and I seem to not lose my I think I had an older computer too, maybe that was it, I don't know.
Yeah, there you go. All right, when we come back, we will investigate who is better at making things up, me or Michael. We'll be right back. All right, welcome back. As most of you know, we usually steal our games from one of those other white straight men whose names start with J. We're also on late night TV. But this one, Jimmy Fallon actually stole from me. This is a game we like to call, Oop, Let Me Sneak Right Past Ya.
Oop, Just Let Me Sneak Right Past Ya.
Now, in Oop, Let Me Sneak Right Past Ya, this is how it works. Both Michael and I have four different words in our hands that we do not know what they are unless you've looked at them.
No, I don't know.
And we're going to have a conversation, and we're going to try and sneak these words into the conversation without you all noticing. Of course, you will notice because the words will be at the bottom of the screen. Now, my freshman year of college, we used to do this where my buddies and I would all get a word, and we'd go into the girls' dormitories to hang out, and we'd all try and sneak in our word, and if you they caught you, you lose the game. So when you say like pantaloons, mm-hmm. and one of the girls like, why did you say pantaloons? You're out, you have to leave. So, are you ready?
Yes.
Can we get a topic to start the conversation about?
Movies.
All right.
Do I have to go in order? Like the first one is the one?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So it's been a while since I've been in a movie theater. When's the last time you were there?
Have you seen, what's that movie? It won the Academy Award.
Best Picture. Toy Story. I'm sure it won an Academy Award.
Yeah, I don't know if it did.
Yeah. I mean, when I was single, I would go and watch Toy Story alone in the theater frequently.
I bet you're seeing Itsy Bitsy Spider a lot, too, when you're single.
Do they have a picture for that? A full-length movie?
I don't know. It just seems like something you do.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nicolas Cage plays the spider.
Yeah. I love the movie. I've seen it twice now.
What is it called?
Parasite.
Parasite, yes. Yeah.
Yeah, that was the last time I was in a movie theater.
That movie is one of those movies where you think that the story is going to end well.
Yeah.
The whole time. And you're like giggling with your friends.
Just it's like when you have pancakes and you pour syrup on it. Pure maple syrup.
Yes, exactly. Right at the start. But then it, in some ways, right at the end, it just turns into a bloody mess, like the good old faithful Detroit Lions every time.
Well, Lions aren't bad every time.
Yeah. But it always starts out where they're pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
And you look at Matt Stafford and you're like, long live the king. And then all of a sudden, boom.
Yeah.
They suck again.
I've noticed no one wears a Calvin lanyard.
Yeah,
is that normal?
We've got some. Somewhere.
Oh, I don't see it. Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're required to wear them.
Okay. I'm just used to that on campus. Everyone has like a lanyard and you guys would have a Calvin lanyard.
Yeah.
Because this is the school.
They get a little itchy. Have you seen the thing that we do with lanyards?
No.
Yeah, here.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, this is one. I don't know where
that's
my
like
lanyard
is.
That's my favorite thing to do.
Old school comedian, yeah. Like, wah, wah.
Yeah, here's my impression of a Calvin student. Hey, Jack, I didn't turn in the assignment for this week.
That seems really inappropriate.
But I just wanted to tell you that I, like, will get you a gift card to Pete's Coffee because Pete's Coffee is great.
Yeah. Please don't.
Do that the whole time.
Yeah.
The doc.
It's really disturbing when they look you in the eyes when they do that. It is.
Yeah. It's a moment.
Yeah.
That you share with students.
Yeah.
Yeah. Speaking of moments that you share with students, how are you feeling about tonight? Do you get nervous before sets?
Sometimes. I don't feel nervous now. It was cool. I got to see the stage area, mm-hmm. and it's cool. It looks like they just cut the grass. So I feel really like it's going to be a great show.
Yeah. You have one more.
That's it.
There we go. That was, let me sneak right past you. Yeah. We've been here with Michael Palascak, who will be performing tonight. And by the time you see this, way in the past. Where can people find you if they want to check out more of your comedy?
Oh, michaelpalascak.com. Also, I have a web series called The Bright Side. It's on YouTube. Oh, it's right here. And Instagram, Twitter, Facebook.
There you go.
Yeah, I have a new album out called The Internet Live, and I have a dry bar special called 1984.
There you go. Yeah. Well, thank you so much.
Thanks.
For being here.
Yeah.
Their new album comes out this Friday. It's called Good Luck With Whatever. Here performing live from his living room is Taylor Goldsmith from Dawes.
The mic strapped to his face, talked about which habits to surrender and which habits to embrace. And for the next few days or so, I was feeling pretty good, but it didn't fix me. I even started volunteering with the local Sacred Heart. We feed the homeless on some weekends. We pick up trash in all the parks. And even though we're cleaning up the whole damn neighborhood, it didn't fix me. Didn't fix me like I thought it would. I got that book you recommended about the spy in East Berlin. Like the way it ended, how he forgives his friend who turns him in. And I think I see what you were saying about how technically it should, but it didn't fix me. It didn't fix me like I thought it would. Didn't fix me. Didn't fix me. I finally got a nomination for an award that I don't need, but I say that out of obligation. I really spent hours on my speech. I think my biggest inspirations and the good folks back in Hollywood. But it didn't fix me. It didn't fix me like I thought it would. It didn't fix me. Loves me for those reasons too. And even though I'm feeling stronger than I ever thought I could, still didn't fix me. Didn't fix me. Didn't fix me like I thought it would. Didn't fix me. Didn't fix me. Didn't fix me.
And that's our show. Thanks so much to Michael Palascak for sitting down with me. Thanks to Taylor Goldsmith of Dawes. If you want to catch more of Taylor performing and my interview with him, tune back in at 9 p.m. this Thursday. We'll be back next week with guest Jane Bruin and Jordan Hamilton. Good night!